Hey everyone, it's Autumn Johnson for NCAA Digital, and it's time for my Power 10 rankings in week 5 of women's college basketball. This might have been the most movement I've done in my Power 10 since we first tipped off the season. Iowa, who sat at number 9 in my rankings, falls out of my top 10 after suffering another upset against Iowa State. When a team falls out, that brings an opportunity for another dominant team to break into my rankings. Here we go. South Carolina owns my number 1 spot once again. So far, the Gamecocks have been untouchable with a 10-0 record. The Gamecocks took down Maryland this past weekend, which makes them 4-0 over top 10 foes. And honestly, I do not see South Carolina losing a game the rest of the way. NC State muscles its way to number 2 after UConn faced a tough upset. The Wolfpack might have fallen to South Carolina earlier this season, but how about a 10-game winning streak since then? NC State has put that first game in its rear view and has proved that its deep and experienced squad deserves to be recognized as a top 2 team in the nation. Stanford moves up to number 3. We haven't seen Stanford on the court since they defeated Maryland on November 27th in the Bahamas. The Cardinal have been resting up and studying during a 2-week exam break, and despite not seeing action in 14 days, Stanford returned with no rust and cruised past Pacific 91-62. Indiana moves up 2 spots to number 4. The Hoosiers defeated Penn State, Fairfield, and then closed out the week with a ranked win over Ohio State. Indiana's elite defense held the Buckeyes' top 4 scoring offense to only 66 points. UConn takes a major hit in my Power 10 and falls 3 spots down to number 5. With a depleted backcourt, UConn was tasked with Georgia Tech and did not get the best of that matchup. In fact, the top 3 defense in the nation held the Huskies to only 1 point in the fourth quarter. However, UConn was able to bounce back against UCLA 71-61. Avina Westbrook and Dorka Juhas stepped up with massive games, and that's what it's going to take for this team to remain dominant. Everyone collectively stepping up in the absence of Paige Beckers, AZ Fudd, and Nika Mule. Louisville and Baylor move up 1 ranking, coming in at number 6 and number 7. The Cardinals use their top-notch defense to take down number 14 Kentucky in the in-state rivalry 64-58. And the Bears are now 9-1 after defeating Alcorn State 94-40. Baylor's next ranked test will be against Michigan on December 19th, and that will be must-see TV in the paint when Alyssa Smith battles Naz Hillman. Maryland drops down 3 spots to number 8. The Terps were hit with their 3rd loss of the season going up against number 1 South Carolina, but they hung close in this matchup. It's no secret that this team needs its full offensive juggernaut. The Terps are still missing top 2 scorer Diamond Miller, who's day-to-day with an injury. Arizona powers its way to number 9. The Wildcats continue their momentum from last year's championship game run to a 9-0 record in the 2021-22 season. This week, Arizona defeated North Dakota State and New Mexico. The Wildcats have been able to carry over its success from last year by staying faithful to its elite defense. In fact, Arizona is currently the top 5 scoring defense in the country. And coming in at number 10, hello, Tennessee. The Vols have been a bubble team along with Michigan, Texas, and Duke for my Power 10 for the past couple of weeks. The undefeated Vols kept their flawless record with notable wins against USF, Texas, and Virginia Tech. This squad is missing star player Ray Burrell, but players like Jordan Horston, Tamari Key, and transfer Alexis Dye have stepped up in her absence. Up next, Tennessee will face Stanford on December 18th. A win over the defending champs could solidify its top 10 spot in my Power 10 and even boost them up in my rankings. That's all for my Power 10 rankings. Follow along weekly for more.